directors that meet there every year are mistaken. We know that the Arab Street is not all that big on these U.S. and Western-imposed dictators, and we're seeing, I think, that play out in Egypt right now.
In fact, that's always been a bigger beef in the Arab and Central Asian nations, that our governments continue to install and fund dictators from the Shah running right through to today with Mubarak. They're more angry about that than the U.S. military presence.
Oh, absolutely. So the people, you know, these commentators that are saying, oh, it's going to be wonderful. We're going to have, you know, new governments in the Arab world. They're going to be moderate. They're going to be pro-Israel. Hey, forget it. The Arab Street, especially the people in Egypt, know how Mubarak has brutalized those aid convoys trying to get into Gaza. They're at one with the people of that beleaguered territory, and they're not going to be sitting down and inviting the head of the IMF and World Bank to Cairo for meetings on austerity plans and the kinds of things we've
seen. So you agree with my analysis then, because people I respect are with really no evidence. I've been seeing claims that the West is involved in this and that it was WikiLeaks that triggered it, but I don't really see that. We've already been seeing unrest. I mean, this really comes down to food.
Yeah, I think what we may have seen, there may be a little bit of truth in what these other folks are saying. I think there's been an attempt to co-opt the opposition in some of these countries to try to tamp it down, control the opposition, and I think that's failed. When we hear in Tunisia the Jasmine Revolution, now we're hearing about the Day of Rage in Egypt and in Yemen and in Lebanon. Well, that all smacks of George Soros-funded themed revolutions. But I think in this case, they've bitten off more than they can chew. We're not going to see them control these revolutions. The governments that come to power know fully well what people like George Soros and Barack Obama and George W. Bush have done to their part of the world, and they're not happy about it.
We're now seeing similar statements to what we saw last year out of Davos from George Soros about how he's having a wonderful crisis. Now he's saying this economic turmoil's been very good for me. He's up there gloating over it. Yeah. And I saw an Associated Press article on Monday out of Davos, headline, Davos calls for $100 trillion in additional credit, which means $100 trillion of taxpayer-backed money for them to then go loan to individuals, corporations, and countries, in some cases as high as 30% annual compounding interest. I mean, these guys are so brazen or chutzpah-filled, oh, yeah. I don't know what term to use, hubris-filled, when they're just saying, give us $100 trillion more. And you know, through the classic fractional reserve banking leverage, that would then be $1 quadrillion or $1,000 trillion. But now through the derivatives model, it's almost unlimited. I mean, this is insane.
Well, I hope these bankers in Davos are watching what's happening in the streets of Cairo, Alexandria, Tunis, Sana'a, Yemen. Because, you know, this is not going to be contained in the Arab world. We're already seeing protests in some of these tin pot dictatorships in Africa, these Western installed leaders there, and we're seeing it play out in Europe. I would note that what's happening in Tunisia and Algeria, let's not forget that there's large North African populations, in for example, in France, and they see Sarkozy as no different than some of these tin horn dictators that they're chasing out in North Africa. He basically was imposed on the French people. And I think we're going to see shockwaves go through some of these European countries. Now, as far as the United States, what happened yesterday, that commission that Obama named on the Wall Street fiasco came out and said, we're all at fault. Now, I'm not at fault. You're not at fault. Who are they talking about?
Well, that's what his State of the Union was about, was this collective guilt, and that if you don't go along with what the bankers say, you don't believe in America anymore, and that we've got to just sit down and have austerity and accept the carbon tax, green jobs that are going to be everywhere, and everything is going to be just fine. This is incredible.
Well, yeah, and I don't know. You know, I don't know what it would take for the American people to, you know, do what they're doing in Cairo. If the American people think they have a representative government, they're sadly mistaken in that, because we saw that play out in the State of the Union, where basically you had a meeting. That's the annual meeting of the oligarchy. and they're all sitting there, you know. Everything is for public consumption. It's sort of like when the Queen opens up Parliament. It's all pomp and circumstance.
Wayne Madsen, what do you make of the statements by Biden that Mubarak is not a dictator? That's like saying if a red cardinal is sitting in the tree outside my backyard that it's not a red cardinal. It's like saying the sun comes up that big ball of ignited gas isn't our sun. Here's the Sydney Morning Herald headline. Revolution is in the air, but U.S. sticks to same old script. Washington appears addicted to propping up tyrants. What's your take on just a week and a half ago, our government saying, don't call, you know, even going after Harry Reid when he finally had a Freudian slip and called who a dictator. Now we're being told that, you know, we're not allowed to talk bad about Mubarak, even though he's a horrible, murdering, torturing dictator. We're told he's a great guy. I mean, what does this say about our government, though, that they love dictatorship? That tells us what type of government they want here.
Yeah, well, that's because we're a dictatorship. Let's not mince words here. I mean, what we hear every day about police brutality in this country and the frittering away of more constitutional rights. I mean, and Biden, as far as Biden's concerned, I mean, this guy always allows his over active mouth override his lack of gray matter. I mean, he's been trying to grow hair plugs for how long now? Well, he needs something. That hair plugs need something to root in, and it's hard to grow them when what's underneath is a vacuum.
Wayne, we're about to go to break, but I wanted to throw this point out. The New York Times and others are reporting, but it's not getting a lot of attention, that in many areas of Alexandria and now Cairo, the police will get into an hour-long, two-hour battle, and then they're just joining as the people, you know, chant, you know, be an Egyptian, don't be a traitor, and the police are throwing down their weapons and going and hugging and joining and giving their water and their Gatorade and things to the people. I mean, that looks like shades of 89 in Romania.
All right, and there's also reports on Al Jazeera that the military is now coming out and flashing the V sign to the protesters. So I would say Mubarak, if he's not at the airport getting ready to fly out, that may happen very soon. And, you know, the U.S. has trained a lot of these Egyptian military officers, but this may be paybacks as well. You know, we trained them. We brought them over here in some cases for training, but they know full well what it's like to be an Arab in the United States. Can you imagine what they faced at the airports, even though they may be traveling with diplomatic passports? You know, you reap what you sow. And if the military takes part with the people in this revolution, I don't think the military's rank and file is all that pro-American.
By the way, Mubarak's now called out the army. They're machine gunning people on the streets, and that caused the police to now remove their uniforms. They've begun joining. That's confirmed. Egypt is about to fall to the people.
New year, new way to smoke, and it's totally wicked. Introducing Totally Wicked e-liquid electronic cigarettes, the highest quality e-cigarettes in the world. With Totally Wicked e-liquid cigarettes, there's no flame, no secondhand smoke, no carbon monoxide, no tar, no unsightly brown teeth or fingers, and no lingering smell. Totally Wicked e-liquid cigarettes have a battery charge that lasts up to 8 hours. Plus, with a Totally Wicked Tornado model, the average pack-a-day smoker is likely to save over $1,000 a year. The Totally Wicked Tornado provides a storm of vapor. See it at totallywicked-eliquid.com. That's totallywicked-eliquid.com. Or call 888-761-9425. Get a 15% discount with promo code GCNLIVE. Go to totallywicked-eliquid.com. Or call 888-761-9425. That's 888-761-9425. Or online at totallywicked-eliquid.com. Totally Wicked e-liquid cigarettes. The next generation of alternative smoking.
They helped to create a new world order.
We are part of a new world order.
A new world order based upon collective action.
Invisible Empire is a damning indictment of the globalists through their own words and documents.
The new world order really is a tool for addressing a new world of possibilities.
It means all the world under their control.
The United Nations would take over America. The Trilateral Commission would control the world.
Invisible Empire chronicles how men of power and influence have worked in stealth for centuries to establish an oppressive world government.
I believe, first of all, that we now need nothing short of a world constitution for the global financial system.
Global governance with the establishment of the G20.
So it's going to be an inner ruling elite and then everyone else. And I got news for you. You're everyone else.
Invisible Empire. Secure your copy today at Infowars.com or PrisonPlanet.com or watch it online in the highest quality at PrisonPlanet.tv.
We all know that Berkey Water Purification Systems are the most trusted name in water filtration. As an authorized Berkey dealer for over 5 years and serving thousands of satisfied customers, the Berkey guy offers amazing specials for Berkey Water Filtration Systems. The Berkey Light Systems include a set of self-sterilizing and recleanable black purification elements that purify water by removing chlorine, pathogenic bacteria, cysts, and parasites to non-detectable levels and remove harmful chemicals such as herbicides and pesticides. Order the Berkey Light System today, complete with two black Berkey elements for only $209, and the Berkey guy will include three Sport Berkey water bottles and ship everything to you free of charge. That's right, three Sport Berkey water bottles and free shipping, an $87 value, yours free. Call the Berkey guy at 1-877-886-3653. That's 1-877-886-3653. Or order online at goberkey.com. That's goberkey.com today.
Arabia, the New York Times and others are reporting that many of the police are now not just hugging and giving their water, which doesn't sound like a lot here, it's a lot there with the population near starvation. And now it's confirmed Mubarak has called out the military to start just shooting people. And the same thing happened with Ceausescu, and then now the police and the military are going to start shooting back. This happens over and over again throughout history. It's touch and go what's going to happen. But this is a very explosive situation with the Suez Canal going through that region. But I tell you, Mubarak, it looks like is in serious danger of being overthrown right now, Wayne Madsen.
I would say so. And I think what the U.S. Should be also concerned about is who's next. We got to remember that the U.S. has been supporting this Saudi regime for a number of years, mostly over oil. And the eastern province of Saudi Arabia has a majority Shia population. If you see them rise up, their natural ally is Iran. What is the United States going to do then? Try to fight Israel's war in Iran and Saudi Arabia? I mean, I think this also sends a message to Israel that things in their neighborhood are changing. And the Palestinians are also watching what's going on. They know that some of their leaders were from these Palestine papers that were released. Some of their own leaders were willing to give too much away.
And remember what happened 3.5 years ago in Lebanon in that several-month war. The main armor columns got beaten. The helicopters got beaten by actually trained people that were in their anti-tank dugouts and were ready to fight to the death. This is a serious situation. How do you see this affecting energy prices? Gold's exploding. I see oil's going up right now.
Well, let's look at the energy countries. There's a thought that Algeria may be next. Of course, that's a big supplier of natural gas to the U.S. If Saudi Arabia goes, there's the price of oil. The eastern province, that's where the oil is. That's where the refineries are. That's where the tankers pull in to load up. So we could see a huge increase in oil prices if this Arab revolt.
And we know what the British and the U.S. have done before. If these Arab uprisings take over those ports, I think you're going to see U.S. special forces sent in to try to secure it, and that's going to be an unbelievable.